listen, I've got no hard feelings towards Chloe whatsoever. I know she's got whatever she wants to say about me.
Yeah, she has kind of accused you of selling stories. Yeah. So do you want to respond to that?
Of course. Listen, I don't need to respond to that, you know. I'm incredibly busy.
He's too busy singing.
Yeah, I've got a lot going on. I've got a lot of shit to make out of that and all.
Hi guys, it's Nathan from Close Online. I've got some very special guests here today from the cast of TOWIE. We've got Junaid, Saffron, Roman and Jordan. How's everyone doing today? All good?
Yeah, really good, thanks.
We're here to talk about the current season of TOWIE. We're on series 30 now, which is crazy. And I think it's fair to say it's been one of the most dramatic seasons of the show so far. I'm going to come to you first, Junaid, because it's your first season as a cast member. How's that been for you?
Do you know what? It's been absolutely amazing. Like, I've loved every single minute of it. And yeah, I'm just enjoying it. Obviously, the show's now on air, so people are kind of seeing the drama unfold and kind of getting to know me as a new cast member. But yeah, absolutely loving it.
How's the public reaction been then since you joined the cast?
Well, do you know what? I'm going to name myself the Christine Quinn of TOWIE because you either love me or hate me.
And who's Christine Quinn?
Do you watch Selling Sunset?
Oh, yeah, the blonde girl,
I'm the Christine of TOWIE. Yeah,
quite liked her, on it.
What did you say? Do you know what? The reaction's been nice. I've had a lot of love. I have had a few trolling comments, but listen, when you're a big personality like me, you're going to get that.
It comes with the territory, doesn't it?
Yeah.
And how about you, Jordan? This is your second time on the show now. You've been away for about 4 years, I think.
Yeah.
So how come you decided to come back to the show? And is it different this time around?
Do you know what? It is. It's very different this time around. Obviously, I had a long time away from it. I was really young last time. I was 21, 22 when I first came on the show and didn't really know where I was in life. Do you know what I mean? Didn't really know what was going on. So then, obviously, went away for 4 years, worked on everything I was doing myself. And yeah, got the call from ITV back in sort of April time. I stayed in touch with a lot of the cast. Me and Seth have been friends since we was children. Me and Lockie obviously remain in contact. Yeah, it just felt sort of right to come back, you know?
Is it nice having him on the show, Saffron?
Because I absolutely
you on
love
the show
it.
Last time, I love with Jordan, were you?
No, we never. Then. I think you left and I came last time. But yeah, I love it.
She's loved having me back. She's absolutely lying.
It's caused a bit of trouble amongst the girls.
Really?
we have seen that's what he's here for, isn't it?
So, we've seen you on the show getting to know Ella, and in one of the recent episodes, you kind of called things off because she was ignoring your texts, basically. Yeah,
liberty, by the way.
So, yeah, it's not on, is it? So, how are things with you now?
I don't want to know.
No, there's a fair bit that unfolds. There's a fair bit that unfolds through the series.
I don't want to know the outcome, though, now. I want to wait and see it.
Yeah, cool.
You've forgot Chloe Brockett.
Oh, don't worry, Saffron, we're going to get to Chloe Brockett. We are going to get to Chloe Brockett.
Did you and Chloe Brockett ever a thing?
That's the question. Obviously, Chloe has come out and said that you were never in an... you were never an item. So do you want to comment on that?
Because me and Chloe, we went out and we had a good time, right? And that was that. There was no item there. We wasn't ever a couple. It was... there was a bit of flirting going on, but that was that. And I've got no hard feelings towards Chloe whatsoever. I know she's got whatever she wants to say about me.
Yeah, she has kind of accused you of selling stories. Yeah. So do you want to respond to that?
Of course. Listen, I don't need to respond to that, you know. I'm incredibly busy.
He's too busy singing.
Yeah, I've got a lot going on. I've got a lot of shit to make out of that and all.
Hello.
Oh, listen, like I said, with Chloe, I think she can... She got her back up about a few things and she can sort of say what she wants. I'm not going to dig her out at all. She's a young girl doing what she wants to do. That's fine. And you'll see that unfold on the show, whether that works out or not. I think it's pretty clear. But you know what I mean? So listen, I'm not going to speak badly of her at all.
He crossed lines between two girls that don't like each other. It was never going to go down well.
I know, but for her to say the comments that she said about Jordan is not right.
No, of course.
It was uncalled for. That's what it was. Very uncalled for.
It did take me a bit by surprise, I'm not going to lie. But then, actually, did it? I don't know.
Are you really surprised that Chloe Brockett said something about you in the press?
But like I said, I'm not going to bad mouth her, do you know what I mean? We're doing our own thing and that's that.
And how's your friendship with Chloe Saffron? Because we saw she made peace with you recently.
It's thriving.
Yeah, good friends.
Best friends forever.
No. Listen, we had a lot of bad blood in the end. When you get compared to Gemma Collins, it's never going to go down well. Not, a BTEC, Gemma Collins, I must highlight. So yeah, so that went all over the press and I thought, you know what, that's a low blow because obviously me and Gemma were good friends, whatever. I've got too many people that I care and love about. It don't faze me anymore. It just don't faze me. To be rowing outside a fish and chip shop ain't my thing, really.
I'm going to come to you, Roman, because one of the biggest talking points of the show so far has been you and Dani and your friendship and your drunken kisses after nights out. Is there any more kisses we need to know about?
No, definitely no kisses need to know about. I think that was the last one. Obviously, when we're both drunk, like, we feel a certain way in it, so just obviously we're better close when we're sober, but when we're drunk, we vibe together in it, so I just tend to do it.
And even outside the show, obviously, like, your love life has been making the headlines. Yeah. You've been linked to a couple of people from Love Island, like Summer and Danica.
Mr. Player over here. This is a serious bench over here.
I'm learning from you,
So what's going on there?
Nothing at all. Summer Island was nothing. That was just, I'll literally just call that nothing. Danica, we just got caught kissing. Obviously, I met her out on a night out and
there was another one.
What?
Another Love Island.
Liberty. So I've done an interview before. They asked me about Liberty. I said we were friends. And obviously, the next day, I'm seeing an article saying new boyfriend. And I'm thinking, I come out of nowhere.
No, so you and Liberty are just friends then?
Just friends.
You've got a lot of friends, haven't you?
Roman and all these friends.
It's so boring.
And also, like Junaid, I'm going to mention Amber Turner now. Obviously, we saw you have an argument with her in the recent episode. Do you think you and Amber will be able to patch things up?
Do you know what? It's a difficult one because obviously me and Amber were very close friends for so many years and so much has happened. Obviously, what you saw on the show was obviously a lot of emotions coming out. I just think for me, like, that ship's just done, personally. Yeah. She's not a type of person that I'd want to be friends with. I know what she's really like inside and out. And I'm on the way up, so I don't need someone like that dragging me down.
And Saffron, we saw you in the recent episode talk about how you're going to move house.
Oh my God.
To the bottom of your dad's garden. So how's the move going? Are you in the shed yet?
Am I in the shed? Basically, my dad now wants to move house completely.
Oh.
So the shed has had plans and the project is underway, but whether I stay in there is a different story, really.
Yeah.
Bit disappointing.
Oh, it was unreal.
That was so funny when I watched it back.
Honestly, you've sat there with Jace.
I ain't seen it.
Oh, I want to meet your dad, by the way.
Yeah, come on.
His jokes.
Poor Jace is proper thinking.
Is your dad going to be on the show anymore? Because I think viewers did love having your dad on the show. It's always nice seeing the cast family, isn't it?
Yeah, so. He's on it a few times more. Yeah, he's got big news in his life. You'll see it. Oh,
nice. It seems like the show's been filmed much more in advance, this series. Mm. So, like, looking back on kind of the episodes that have been, do you wish you'd done anything differently, any of you? Or are you happy with how the show's played out so far?
I think this series has been the best one for me so far, 100%. Especially the way it's been filmed as well. I think it's much better finding out yourself while watching with the viewers as well.
It's been different this time around. For me, coming back, obviously, it's been a long time since I've been here. And then coming back, I think it definitely works better. We're seeing it as
a viewer.
It's like the realest it's ever been when it comes to the arguing and or like the drama that's going on. I think because you really are hearing from other people what's going on. There's nothing we're seeing that you... Do you get what I mean?
Yeah.
It's a lot more realistic.
I think as well, suspense from us. I mean, I look forward to every Sunday watching the show thinking, what has everyone said about me? What are people saying? No, I mean, honest though, I think from my point, because we don't know what people have said. So when I've watched it back, I'm thinking, wow, and everything we filmed, we all filmed not knowing what anyone else was saying. So we were speaking the truth from our side. So, I think it makes it a lot more kind of like exciting for the viewers and also us.
Okay, guys, can you tell us then when we can catch TOWIE on TV? Junaid?
TOWIE is on ITVB every Sunday, 9 p.m. And you can also catch it on the ITV Hub.
There you go, so make sure you tune in.